I'm Lisa Carberg. Welcome to Money Wisdom, sponsored by Johnson Brunetti. We're educating you about smart ways to manage your money. And joining us is Eric Hogarth, certified financial planner and Johnson Brunetti partner. Eric, welcome.
Hi, Lisa. Good morning.
Hello. So today we're talking action steps to take and avoid in a bear market. Eric, you've mentioned during the segment we're all due for a market correction. Well, now it's here. And what should people do and not do? First, let's talk about steps not to take.
Yeah, so the market had been going up and up and up and up. And of course, we talk about, well, one of these days it'll go down, and no one really thought that this would be how, but we find ourselves here. So it's natural to be emotional and panic, but step number one, try not to panic. Don't make a quick reaction. And now we find ourselves a few weeks into this, and people are settling into what is my plan and what should I be doing? But initially, you don't panic, and you don't immediately do something that you might regret.
Okay, let's talk about now, do not check your portfolio balance every day. Talk about that.
Yeah, stop it. Don't do that. Don't do that, unless maybe it's your job. But if you're looking at it every single day, you almost guaranteed are going to convince yourself to do something that you shouldn't be doing. Right now, if you're very, very concerned about the risk exposure that you have, and it was so exciting when the market was going up, and now we find ourselves here, it is also still important to remain, you know, mindful of the fact that the market is still really, really up relative to where it was 5 years ago, 10 years ago. It's lower than it was a couple months ago, but maybe it is time to take less risk. And if you're looking at your screen every day, that's indicative that it might be your time.
Okay, next step, do not cash in your 401k. Talk about that.
So this is all relative to where you are in life, but if you are not yet 59 and a half and you're thinking about doing that, you're probably going to get definitely going to get a penalty, plus all of the taxes, plus you need that money to retire in the future. You know, so a lot of people are faced with some very, very difficult situations and decisions right now, and that's why I encourage you, get some advice. I mean, you can call us, you can call other folks, but have a conversation about what makes the most sense, because there are alternatives. Loans can be gotten at very low interest rates right now, and a lot of times that makes more sense than cashing out your retirement money before you really want to be doing it.
Great advice. All right, now let's talk about steps to take in a bear market. Number one, keep calm and keep emotions in check.
As best as you can, right? You think about your plan and what your timeline is. If you're 30 years old, right? Well, we want to be saving as much as possible. And really, at any age, you want to be saving as much as possible right now. But it's all relative to time. None of us want to see our accounts going down. But those of you that have been in the market for years and years and years, well, they do. Sometimes they go down and sometimes they go up. And the longer time you have, the more likely it is that you're going to be able to get good growth.
All right, next step, take advantage of dollar cost averaging. Explain that one to us, Eric.
So let's say you look at the market every day and you're timing the absolute best time that you're going to buy Apple stock as an example. And it goes up and it goes down and it goes up and it goes down. The likelihood that you are going to time it perfectly and buy it at the cheapest possible price, you won't. But what if you bought it every single day? Sometimes it was expensive and sometimes it was less expensive, but you're always buying, buying, buying and saving. Dollar cost averaging is that, so that it brings your overall cost down and your likelihood for growth up.
Okay, and finally, make sure your plan is diversified. Talk about that.
The market was a fantastic place to be over these recent years of going up and up and up. But if your whole retirement plan and your growth strategy, particularly if you're getting close to retirement or into retirement, is based on, well, the market's going to come back and it's going to go up. It might not. There's been decades when the market was effectively up and down and up and down, but flat. So you can't rely on the market as your full retirement plan if you're in retirement or about to retire. I'm a believer in it, but your whole world can't be there because there's things that outside of the market that are designed to generate income or that provide safety. So make sure you have balance in what you're doing, not just in the market.
Okay, great advice. And you have an offer for us today. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so this is what to do in a down market. You can get this by going to www.moneywisdomtv.com, and it'll walk through a checklist of things to be thinking about. It might help you to reduce your anxiety and the emotional reaction to all these things, and just take a step back and look at, all right, what is my plan? And if you don't have one, it's okay. It's a great time to get one. And if you have one, make sure that you're still on track with where you want to be. So again, www.moneywisdomtv.com. We'll get it to you. It's absolutely free. We're here for you. You want to have a conversation. But I encourage you to get it because I think it'll help give some calm.
Okay. Thank you, Eric Hogarth from Johnson Brunetti. And to learn more, go to moneywisdomtv.com.